I have to do a long one because I think Justin needs to go and get a cuppa. Don't think I can do one long enough for you to boil the kettle. How are we all? Hope you're all well. Just get the iPad up and running so I can just at least keep an eye on the chat over here as well. So, in the... Be quiet. I don't want to hear myself. So, yeah, in this stream, I'm going to be trying to build a complete affiliate marketing website, which is probably quite ambitious. And I've got about 2 hours or so to do it in because that's when the school run is. So, we'll see how that works. Obviously, it's going to be completely unedited. And, yeah, we'll just hopefully get a site finished by the end of the stream. When I say finished, you know, kind of ready to go, maybe with an article on it, possibly. And yeah, we'll see how that pans out. Lots of familiar faces in the chat. Phil's in, server expert extraordinaire, and of course WP Eagle member. You can see that because he's got special color for his name, a lovely green. And there's Marketing Ghost, another fantastic WP Eagler. And yeah, they've got little eggs next to their name as well, which will hatch. We can't wait for them to hatch. They're going to hatch into a mighty eagle. And Sue. Sue is there as well. It's another WP Eagler using the emotes to good effect. Fantastic. So let's do a few other hellos. A hello to Justin. I've already mentioned you. I hope you got a nice cup of tea. That was very quick. Hello, Mark. Hello, Dave. Hello, Jim. Hope you're good. Hello, Koo. I replied to your email just a minute ago. I do apologise if I've got chocolate around my face. It's very bright in here. I think I'm going to lose that light. I don't need that. It's too bright. I'm also looking a bit yellow, aren't I? A little bit yellow. Do we need this light? Let's turn that one off as well. Maybe that's better. Because the sun's out, so I'm a little bit yellow. I'm wondering if I just need to... maybe I've got jaundice or something. Let's just adjust this this colour temp a little bit. I don't know if I'm going to do that on the fly. Anyway, it doesn't matter because we're going to be looking at the screen anyway. It's not focusing. Focus. There we go. Hello. Focus. I'm here. Camera. Hey. So, I think we should get on the computer and get started. I think I look a little bit better now. Manny, oh, I just see you got a question there. Let's see. So Manny asks, I have some digital affiliate products that I want to promote on a website. Will this course help? I want to get your thoughts on Thirsty Affiliate. I've never heard of Thirsty Affiliate. You probably don't need a course though. Digital affiliate products sounds interesting. Generally, if you just create some good content on a good site, you'll be fine. But if you want to purchase the course, go for it and then let us know how it goes. Kevin, is it cold up in Norfolk? It's a little bit chillier here as well today. Jim's got to do some work. He's not going to be around for long. Main incomes, eh? They need work doing on them. Thomas Holt. Good to see you. Holt is up in North Norfolk, isn't it? Coincidence. That's a lovely seamless link. Hope you've got a cup of tea. You're going to need one. Hello, Benno. Love the emoji. You got this. Bell Bridge, good to see you. Sun's out in Devon. Good to hear. The sun is out, but it's not as warm as it's been. Anyway, we're going to transition and get on the computer. Hey, here we are. Kevin, yes, sharing. You're up the road from Holt then, of course. Lisa. Good to see you. Where's SC? I guess that's in the States somewhere. What does that stand for? SC? South California? I don't know. So the site I'm going to be building today is this one. It's bestpressurewasher.com. I think a lot of you will be familiar with this niche. It's a niche that I hunted down on Amazon, went into Home and Garden, and saw pressure washers. They're of a reasonable value. They're around $100 and upwards. South Carolina, of course. And yeah, I'm going to be doing it on this niche. Yes, I found some pressure washers, did some research, and there's a lot of article potential with it because a lot of people searching for, you know, best pressure washer for this and that and whatever. It is quite a competitive niche, so we're going to have to see how we get on with it. But you know, I'm up for a challenge. Why not? Ku says, I saw a video by Ferdy Kopaschuk. I can never pronounce his surname. On a 3 hours building an affiliate marketing website. Yeah, it's fantastic, isn't it? Ferdy does some fantastic videos. He's far better YouTuber than me. I did feel a little bit of anxiety when I saw that video because I know he's just going to kill it with that. He's already got way more views than any of my videos. But hey, whatever. Love Ferdy. He seems to have a lot more time and energy to do videos than me. I don't know what that is all about. Hi, Steve. Good to see you. Hi, all. I have an interest in garden wildlife, especially birds. Do you think that is a good idea for an affiliate blog site? Yeah, though I don't know how much money can be made out of bird products and bird seed and stuff. I'll be glad to be in the corner of your screen, Bradbury. Right, the tea's gone. Let's crack on. So, I guess you can see, let me just resize this browser. Actually, I'm wondering if it might be better to make you all go full screen to share the whole screen, because I'm going to show you some other things. We'll do that in a minute. Just want to make sure all the confidential stuff is out of the way. Not there is any. Hi, Maud. Good to see you. So, I've got this far, and let me tell you where I'm at. So I've got some hosting. If you need some hosting, I still recommend SiteGround. You'll find a link to them in the description. It's an affiliate link, so if you use it, thank you very much. Sign up with their WordPress hosting, and then you will get a site with WordPress ready to go. Alternatively, you can, of course, get in touch with Phil, who is in the chat, and you can reach him also via my website. Go to wpeagle.com, go to services, go to hosting, and then you can fill in a form and get in touch with Phil, and he'll sort you out a site as well. It's really up to you. The next thing I've done is I've installed Thrive themes. Again, you'll find a link to it in the description. It's an affiliate link. Again, thank you very much if you use it. Just decided to use Thrive today. I'm going to be doing some other sites with Oxygen and Brizzy and stuff real soon, but I've been playing around with Thrive quite a bit, so I thought, why not, let's do Thrive today. Hi, good to see you, Zulkan. Justin, if a niche has not many high ticket items on Amazon, would you say it's still worth it? Not as worth it. Remember, Amazon commission from Amazon.com is only up to, you know, 3 or 4% maximum. So, you know, if it's $10 items or whatever, it's going to be really hard to make any good money. Lisa's bought Oxygen, she's not used it yet. You must be up quite early, Lisa. Well, what is the time where you are? French or English blog? I think probably most niches in the English, UK, US markets are probably quite saturated. There's a lot more competition. So French, there may be less competition. 11 past 8, perfect time. So yeah, I've got Thrive. Again, I say, you'll find the link in the description. Go check it out. With Thrive, what they do is they give you a little plugin to install this one called the Product Manager. And then you can easily install everything you need. So I've installed Shapeshift, which is the theme with the theme builder. Thrive Theme Builder. That'd be a good name for it, yep. And now I'm going to install the Thrive Architect. Ah, cool. I do love you. And that rhymes. Where's stupid robot fighting me when you need it? Look, I'm not ashamed for a few days. He'd be proud. Be careful, Bradbury, doing things like that. You may break the space-time continuum. So, right, we've got Thrive Architect installed. So that's basically like the Elementor, the content builder, whatever. So I think we should start with the homepage and add the logo and all that kind of stuff. And we'll see how it goes. I see, Paul, but what if the site is UK focused? Surely that's more beneficial. You'd think. I'm going to try and do your questions as we go. So first thing I'm going to do is create a home page. I'm going to go to new page. Hello, block editor. Call it home and click publish. There we go. Let's launch the Thrive Architect. Now, keep in mind, I have not used Thrive that much. So if I get lost, confused, which I will, just bear with me. Do you think we should go for normal page? I think we'll go for normal page. That sounds good. Here we go. So I think we should start with the theme builder because we need to do this like header and footer and stuff. So let's do that. What are your guys' thoughts on country-specific domains like .co.uk? My personal gut feeling is that if your site is looking for UK traffic, then a .co.uk is always going to rank better than a .com. But I don't know. And my other question for you, I don't know if Phil or any of you guys might know this. Yeah, I know .com all the way. So, okay, Justin, let's go back. I'll ask the other question in a second. I'm always all over the place, aren't I? Here's one for you, Justin. So with Wheel Along, I've got wheelalong.com, wheelalong.co.uk. I recently switched to .co.uk because it is a UK targeted site. Do you think that was the right thing to do? Because I'm thinking, I guess with the .com, I could just set up a US focus site, or should I just have one site? There's so many questions. Hey, Josh is here. I'm a little bit early because I needed a few hours to do this. Right, let's do this header. Let's do this header. Now, do you think I should go for this kind of my standard logo in the middle deal? Or maybe we should go for something else? Maybe like this. Left. People are saying logo left, logo left. Okay. A nice one with a logo on the left. That's a lovely WooCommerce one. I'm gonna have to build a WooCommerce site soon. I've got a tutorial I need to do on that. I like having a search bar, but I mean we can edit it. We can edit. We just need to start with something. I think I'm going to go for this, just this kind of simple one, and then I'm going to switch the call to action to a search. Let's have a look. Template was not saved. Why on earth not? Don't think top level domains have an effect on ranking. Yeah, that was my question. Does a .com outrank a .net, for example? What is, why are we not saving? What is happening here? Let me refresh. Okay, let's just edit this. So yeah, I want to switch this for a search. Oh, I didn't want to do that. This call to action here. So is this part of the menu? Obviously it is, looking at it. Oh, loads of menu templates as well. This is good, I like it. Let me go for this one. Okay, so that's just like a menu item, that call to action. That's fine. We're going to do a new menu in a minute. I'll spend a little bit, Jim, yeah. Because I've been looking for some more domains for some other sites and the .coms have all gone. They're all like premium. They all want loads of money. So I'm thinking for an affiliate site, like a .info might work well. Maybe. Anyway, I want to add a little search up here. There we go. Yep. Let's do this a little smaller. It's not leaving much room for the nav though, is it there? That might be, it's a bit small. Maybe it should go here. There. Ditch that. Let's make that bigger again. Can we make this full width? Yep. Whoa. And this, what's happened here now? Why are you gone on two? Okay, I'm going to replace this header because I've messed it up. Maybe I should just pick one with a search in it already. What's that one look like? That might be okay. Let's get the logo in. That's always a good good thing to do. I created a logo in Canva, which I should have to hand somewhere. Where have you got? Here we go. Not very big, is it? That's better. I don't know if I want these social things right here, right now. Okay. I guess this is the same for dark. I mean, I'm not going to have a dark header, I don't think. Is that too big now? 200? Maybe we go 180. I'm gonna have to type it. Add a link to logo. The logo should always link back to the homepage, shouldn't it? Yay, it's done. Okay. Let's preview. I'm still not sure about the header. I really like my the centered one. I don't know, it's just me. I don't know. I've not used the affiliate plugin called Balzac. What's Balzac? Sounds rude. Maybe if I make the eight to nav a little bigger, that might look better. My logo is not quite centered or lined up. It's fine, I guess. I guess up here, what I could have is a little menu again for like the other links. I don't know. I'm just not feeling this header. OK, going to have a look at the others. Someone said the blue one looks nice. Like this one, that's quite nice. But yeah, the blue is not going to work for me on this logo unless I change the logo in Canva. But I'm sure I could change this color, couldn't I? Let's have a look. Just switch that to white. Actually, maybe I should unlink it from theme color and just do this. There we go. Then we'll have to make this different color. That can be blue. We'll go for blue, because you know, water's blue, and yeah. I want to change the colors of this little texting. Format with button. I like the button. Yep, with button. Here we go. We want the theme color again. Okay. Although, actually, to be fair, let's just have a look at that. Did save, didn't it? Yeah, Lisa, you can change the colour. What's happened now? Have I broken this? I guess the blues, I might look better white. It might look better white. This. Just give me the white. White, and then make the background of this box blue. What do you reckon? What do we reckon? Let's try it. Ah, now we're getting somewhere. Starting to pop. Okay. For some reason, it's freaking out when I'm trying to preview. There we go. Look at that. Lovely. Now we're rocking and rolling. You've got to play around with these sites, haven't you? You've got to just keep tweaking until it just... Mwah! It's fantastical, as they say in Rome, possibly. All right, let's do this. Let's get this sorted. We do need some pictures. We're going to get some pictures in a minute, Koo. Going to get some lovely lovely pictures of jet washes. So this is, actually I want to, let's go back. I think we just need a blank page for the homepage, don't we? No, I'm in the wrong place. Thank you, Lisa. We have hardly got anywhere yet. Hopefully it's going to get a little bit better. Yeah, I want a blank page with a header and footer. That's what I want. Where's... Actually, I need to save that header, don't I? I'm going around the houses here. I do apologize. Okay, I just get me. See, when I'm doing a video, normally I just would edit all this, and then you'd never see that. I've broken this. Look, there we go. Where's my? It's on the homepage, isn't it? Let's set that homepage as the homepage. Settings, general. Oh, I need to update that. I actually want it to go to reading. There we go. Good to have you on, Solomon. Okay, I'm completely confused. What's happened now? I'll edit this out later. Did I actually just wipe all the work I'd done by switching that template? Jesus. Did I? Because it seems to have disappeared. What's this one? Oh, there it is. It's this one, generated homepage. Of course it's generated homepage. Of course it is. Okay. Let's trash this one then. We don't need that. We don't need that. It's all coming together lovely. So generated homepage. I'm just going to call this homepage because that makes more sense. Yeah, oxygen is going to be in the next video. Right, let's go back in and reading again. Okay. What? Where's my heading gone? How bizarre. Right, let's do that again then. We know what we're doing. Yeah, maybe I still prefer Elementor. I do at the moment. Okay, what did we go for? We went for this fantastic looking one. Yeah, I'm not selling it well, am I, this theme? Then we're going to change. Oh, no, we've done that. We need to change the color here. Going to say, hang on, when I finish doing it, I'm going to save it. We went for this to the white, like that. We went for this to being the blue. Hey. This to the blue. Divi, well, no, it's still better than Divi, I think. This background is going to be the blue. Save. I'm going to save this as the best pressure washer header. Perfect. Right. Good. I think we're laughing. Are we laughing? I don't know. Let's have a look. We've got a header, we've got a footer. Let's do this footer as well while we're here. Yeah? Why is it 180? I find it clunky and slow and all that stuff. Thanks, Steve. I'll try. I'm not quite sure what you mean, but I'll try and figure that out. Okay, let's theme build this up. I kind of like this one, but let's have a look what we've got. Replace. That's okay. I want something quite simple. The centered logo is okay, sort of. The new site is bestpressurewasher.com. Okay, I guess we're gonna have to, we'll just go with this and we'll just edit this. We'll change this background to be the lovely blue. Perfect. Excuse the noise, the bin men are here. I think these, they are white. They've got a bit of opacity or something going on, haven't they? Let's just make it white. I like my white to be white. Nothing wrong with a bit of opacity. Now and again. Opacity. I don't know. Yeah, there must be a quick way to change all these colours, you think? At the end of the day, I'm probably just going to drop menus in here. But we'll come back to that when I've got some more stuff. Is there a way I can save this? If I unlink it, does that link it? Oh no, here we go. Best pressure washer footer. I love paperweight. Thank you. There's the theme colours. All right, we'll play with that in a minute. Okay. Let's preview. Okay. I think it's getting there. Let's do this homepage. Just get the homepage. Once you've got the homepage done, you're practically finished, aren't you? Yeah, this video will be available afterwards. I think I just said that. So, we need to start with a block. Got it. Content blocks, theme blocks. Show me all the blocks. So I think I'm going, something simple, a nice image and a little bit of text. Something like, I'm tempted by this one already. I mean, if I look at all the heroes. Eighteen likes so far. Thank you very much for your likes. If you've not got round to liking yet, then you could do it right now. Or like this one. Got some rounded corners. Should we go rounded corners? I think we should. It's interesting, isn't it? I like this side. I don't know about this bit. Don't know what your thoughts. Yeah, similar, Justin. What is in the settings here? Okay. Let's change this for a jet wash and see what we get. We'll change this. Why is this a little bit of a different colour? Where's that set? Because it's black, so why is this bit not black? What's that about to do? Ah, it's template, okay. I want this bit blue. Best pressure washer. For your needs. I want best pressure washer to be all on one line. Why is it not on one line? It was a second ago, wasn't it? Guess if we just I don't really want to. Lisa, you might need to just change your YouTube quality. Change the black, what black? Okay, we'll change this to say something like what blurb have I got on Best Roof Box? I'm just going to be inspired by that blurb. Okay, yeah, we'll do something similar to that, won't we? Simon, hello. Did you do a Google PageSpeed test on the auction site you built on in your recent analyze team? Did it work out to be any faster? Yeah, I think I did, and it was faster. It's definitely faster. I know that. With hundreds of pressure washers available to buy, it can be an overwhelming. See, now that's got wider. Task to find the right one for your needs. We're here. Should I say experts? I always think that's a bit strong, but why not? Are here. What did I put on bedroom? Okay, that's better. I like the kind of here on. It's pretty good. I wonder who wrote that. It was me. I can't even find the right tab. Find the best pressure washer for your next cleaning challenge. What I'm going to do, actually, let's just save. Well, let's get this image, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add some categories and start linking some stuff together. Another site. Yeah, I know. I've got too many sites. Right, to get a nice image, I'm going to head over to... I've got too many tabs. Get rid of these tabs. Kill them off. I'm going to head over to iStock. I should have put a link to this in the description, but it's wpeagle.com/... What is it? wpeagle.com/iStock photo, like that. It's an affiliate link. I do appreciate it if you use it. It'll take you straight here, like that. Let's see what we get for pressure washer. Do you think pressure washer or jet washer? Are they the same thing? Just a different way of saying it. Look at these, lovely. Power washer. Power washer, pressure washer, jet washer, I don't know. Roof cargo box or roof box? I like that, that's nice. It's got a kind of action shot going on. Power washer. Power washer sounds good, doesn't it? Best power washer. You go get that now. Exclude nudity. Oh, boring. I suppose we are live. We don't want to. Look at that. That would have made a good logo, wouldn't it? I like that as well. I quite like that. But I like this one with the... Oh, look at that. That would have made a fantastic logo as well. The best way to find out what people search for, Ray, I guess you're probably doing this, Google Trends. Let's see, what's the verdict? Is it pressure washer? It's a bit late now, I've got the domain name, but there's pressure washer, jet washer. Or is it Jet Wash, do you think? Not Jet Was. Jet Wash? No, neither is doing it. Power Washer. Okay, there we go. Power Washer's actually got a little bit of traction. Definitely Pressure Washer is the winner there, though. You should. It's good advice, Bradbury. Good advice. Let's have a look at the UK. Okay, in the UK, we like a jet wash more than a power washer. So there's a difference there between the US and the UK. Pressure washer still rules, but there's a difference between power washer, jet washer between the two countries. Phil, you're damn right there. Definitely seasonal. Everyone wants a pressure washer in, when's this? April? April, so we get the site ranking by April, we'll be fine. Anyway, I think we should, these are lovely logos. I wish I'd come here. I just made the logo in Canva, as I already said, and I picked up an icon from somewhere, changed the colors on it. That's how we ended up where we are. So I'm gonna go for this one. Looks lovely. Let's sign in. Ugh, let me. I don't know where my password manager's gone. No, there it is. No pressure, washer. Right. Let's save this in here. Now, I wonder what kind of size we're looking at. How big is this image here? Why does that not appear in the media library when it's obviously is a media? I don't know. Let's just resize it down to a reasonable size. We'll do that in Photoshop. This is where I'm going to need to share my whole screen with you, I think. Let me try that without sharing anything too much. There we go. It's very clever because it's not showing you all of the eCam stuff, all of the live streaming stuff. So yeah, let's drop this into Photoshop. Okay. It's 384 pixels, we were saying. So let's resize this. It's very big at the moment. I'm going to say 400 wide. Now that image is kind of portrait, isn't it, in its kind of orientation. So I'm wondering if it's worth kind of just cutting it a little. Let's see what happens if we do that. We'll do that by just adjusting the canvas size. Actually, I should have, let me go back a bit. Pixel is a good way to adjust image as well if you don't want to use Photoshop. I probably should use that. I'm not very good at Photoshop. Let's just do a little crop. That might be the easiest thing to do. I think it's something like that, just to give it a little bit more of a portrait thing going on. And then we will do the image size down to 400. Let's export and see what we get. Put the quality down a bit, try and get the file size down. It's 59, that's good, 59 kilobit. Homepage, pressure washer. Let's just call it best pressure washer. Why not? Home. Let's replace this image. Let me just switch you back to Chrome because it's a little bit small, isn't it? There we go. Actually, I notice it doesn't show you my kind of file thing. Anyway. Okay. It's got like, it's made it black and white. So what is that? Ah, this grayscale. I think we're gonna ditch that. Yeah, I like color. Can I make it any higher? Ooh. Okay, let's undo. No, redo that. I want to get rid of the grayscale. I don't know, let's have a look, see what that looks like. I kind of want it to be the same height as this, but maybe, do I need that? What do you think? I think it would look better if it was the same height. I don't know. I don't know. What are these different templates that you mess with? Okay. Just breaks it. Finding a niche within the pressure washer niche? No, I think I'm niched enough. Niched enough with just pressure washers. I don't think I need to go any deeper. Got a fixed width of 98%. Okay, that moves that. The height is got a minimum. I mean, I guess the thing is, the height of the picture was only 4.59, so it's not going to go any higher, is it? Maybe moving it up a little bit is better. Anyway, let's crack on. We can play around with home pages till the cows come home, can't we? When are the cows home? What time are they going to be home? I don't think the eagle likes cows. I think it would kind of eat cows. Anyway, so next we need the recent posts. That's what we need, some lovely recent posts. But before I do that, I'm going to sort out this nav. So let's save and return to post editor. And then let's go in here. Then let's go into posts and categories. And the first category, we're going to have buyer's guides. I should probably think of better categories. I like to just keep it simple. Buyer's guides, beginner's guides. You know, I've got a formula. I'm not going to change it. The one thing I do need to know is how to spell beginners. Is that right? I can never spell beginners. Yay, got it right this time. I can't spell many words, if I'm honest. But that is one that I do struggle with. Not beginners, beginner's guides. There we go. And let's just create a couple of pages, just blank pages. We'll play with them later. Let's do a contact us. And nope. Let's do a about us. Okay, let's set up our new menu. We've got menu one. We'll use that. I'm going to call it main menu there. There's home page. Let's call that home. And we don't want sample page. I don't want blog for now. About us, contact us, and then we'll add these categories. This and this. You start, I put buyer's guides first, that's most important. Perfect. Then let's set this as the main menu. Over here. And get me head around this. We're getting there slowly, aren't we? Edit. Aha. Like it. Let's take a look. I like it actually. That's different size image is fine. It's kind of arty, isn't it? Yeah. Okay. Let us add a little bit more to this homepage. So. Let's add a posts. We've got posts in here. I don't know if that's a block. Is that a block or is that a widget? Blog. Lists. I'm sure we found it. Before, didn't we? I haven't, Steve. I have to check them. We'll have a look at that in a sec. Maybe it was. Let's just go back in here. Was it this one? Let's have a look. Yeah, that's what we want. That's what we want. Ku says the search bar is a little bigger than it should be. Maybe. Let's have a look. We'll have a look at that in a sec. What are you thinking? What are you thinking? Look at all these lovely, lovely, lovely posts. I mean, something like this is perfectly fine, isn't it? Something like that. With like three columns. You got the grid, you got the list. I think grid's fine. I want excerpt. Six items is fine. Show entire, no. Read more is fine. What is in here? Edit design. Okay, I don't want this. Perfect. I'm going to add an article in a minute, but what I'll do, what we'll do is we will set up a quick couple of dummy articles just to fill it out a little bit, just so I can see what the heck I'm doing here. I need to decide a size for the thumbnails. So best roof box I went for. What size are the best roof box thumbnails? Because we'll go for something similar. I think they are. Let me just switch you back. You can see what I'm doing. I'm doing some stuff in Photoshop. There's a Tesla. How big is this? $1050 by $501. Let's say $1050 by $500 sounds perfect. So $1050. Perfect. And then we're just going to crop this. Not centimeters. Okay. This is just a dummy little featured image. Maybe yellow as a site color. I wanted to go blue because water's blue. I know. Thrive is a page builder and a theme builder, Solomon. Kind of does both. Okay, let's just add a bit of dummy content. We'll add some real content as well if we get time. Time is ticking. I've only been in this an hour. Wow. Give me some lorem ipsum. I know I should use that plugin you recommended, Phil, to generate a load of dummy content, but we'll just do this for now. Perfect. Should probably edit this with Thrive, but it's only a simple thing, isn't it? Oh, hang on, I didn't add that featured image. Okay. And then what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to add a fantastic little plugin, one of my favorites. You know what it is. So does anyone know what happened with this? So it was not by Yoast. It was probably by this guy, Enrico. And has Yoast bought it, taken it? What do they want with a duplicate post plugin? Yeah, Bradbury, definitely. Okay. We've got Yoop. Big name for it. Yoast Duplicate. So, also, this is in the wrong category. Let's put this as a buyer's guide. Clone. Brush washers for me. It's just demo content, you know. We just need to get our layout sorted. What that plugin does, it just allows you to quickly make a copy of your content. It was in my last video, actually. You can check it. So if you want to quickly make a copy of something, you can either have clone here or new draft. So let's just do new draft. Best pressure washer for Cuckoo. And publish. Okay, good. We've got three posts now. Perfect. Clone is available without that plugin, are you sure? Here we go. Here we go. I'm actually thinking that excerpt, well, maybe I should have just set it as a number of words. Let's do that. Are you sure Clone is available without that plugin? I'm going to check that in a sec. Let's just do it as words. Yeah, it's a bit shorter. So what other options we got around here? We've got a body, got shadows. No shadow. Don't want a shadow. Um, Could have an image back. I don't think we need image backgrounds or anything like that. Your padding and stuff. I kind of like that slide, that works well. Alignment. I think it's fine actually, I think it's fine. What I will add is some text above here. Latest pressure washer articles, we'll make that a heading one, we'll center it. It's good. It's good. Link to Thrive Builder is in the description. It's an affiliate link, of course, and I do really appreciate it if you use any of my links. It really does help me out. Oh, H2, yes. Okay. Thanks, Phil. What is this text? That's H2.2. Okay. I'm wondering if that should be a little bit, or maybe it should even be a H3. Yeah. Thanks, Phil. Yeah, I'm one step behind you. We could always make this a little bigger, I guess. Couldn't we make it a little bigger? Okay, in Thrive, where is the... I guess it's in the theme. How do I set the global fonts? Anyone know where that is? I mean, I don't mind this font, but I think unless it must be in here, mustn't it, in the Thrive theme builder. I think we should just have a look at a couple other fonts. That's just colors. Thrive options. Okay, well, back in here, Steve. In here. It can't be in here. No, it's not in here, surely. WordPress menu, go into five options. Okay. Should I save? I guess so. In here. What is this? Well, I need to do an update? What's going on? Oh, okay. No wonder I'm struggling here. Go to Thrive, theme builder, third one down, not the second one. Oh, okay, right, yeah, here we are. Wow. There's a lot of options with this builder. I see, I like it. It's opening lots of tabs. Yeah. So we can just come in here, we can change it. Wow. I love a bit of Lato, but I don't know. Monsterat is quite nice. Newton, what's your favourite font? Bit of Open Sans. Quicksand. That's friendly, isn't it? Let's try that. Let's go with a bit of Quicksand. Is there not a way to change all of them in one kind of hit? Thank you. Thank you, Steve. Steve, I'm glad you're here, man. You helped me out today. I guess when you know, don't you? When you don't know like me, you just have to click around all day and hope that it... Oh, hello, Scum. Didn't see you there. Let's take a look. There's nothing to preview. That's nice. Let's see what that's done to the site. I like it. Okay, I mean, I think there's a little bit too much space there, isn't there? There's a little bit too much space. Thanks for your font tips there, Phil. So that's the spacing there. Yeah, that's fine. I want to, it's in here, is it? I want to. No. Just this height here. Needs to be more than 20. What are we saying, 50? 60? That looks better. And again here. Okay, I think that looks better. I think that looks better. Let's crack on. Now, I've just had a big tea and I need to go for a little, I need to use the little facilities. So bear with me a second and I'll leave you with some lovely music. I've got a new screen. Here we go. I can think now. Bro says you don't get income still going from midstream stream. Well, there's loads of people there. They can just do shifts like that long stream they did. They were just doing shifts, weren't they? I get it. Sometimes, you know, when you got to go, haven't you? You got to go when you got to go. That Okay, that's pretty cool. Now it's just switching between whichever application I'm using. That's good. So what we need now, I'm just going to add a little bit of something nice down here. Another lovely, lovely block. Something with a nice image. Some text. Probably another hero. I like this. Was it a call to action? Let's get rid of that. It probably is a call to action. Oh, there's so much nice stuff, isn't there? Illustrated lists. Definitely going to be using these pros and cons when we're doing a bit of content. Okay, I'm just taking too long here. We need to move on, don't we? I think a nice big one. I think this one, I'm going to go with this one. Here we go. I think like that. There's that white gap again. You remember? So this is sitting over on the left. I'm just wondering why is it? Is there a way I can move this? Okay, to the right, for example. Got this block. I think that's why they have staff, yeah, so they can go for a wee whenever they want to. Any ideas why this is over to the left and how I could make it go to the right? Layout and position, I guess, would be the way to do it. Bit of margin is doing. I mean, I don't know if I want to add that much margin. I know that's just going to break on a phone. Although, to be fair, it looks fine on a phone. Although these don't look, I've completely broken these, haven't I? Yeah, we need to fix that. It looks okay on tablet. You'll also know how to do these as a landscape phone. Ryan, hi, I got kicked out of the Amazon Associates program. No. Do I need to replace all my links? You do. However, did you follow my advice and use the long links? Okay, we need to edit this thing here. Don't we need to edit. The post lists on here because it needs to be one column, of course it does, for a phone, of course it does. That's better, 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 better. No, okay, you didn't use the long links. So the reason why I say always use the long links, in fact, someone asked me this today, when you're on your Amazon, let me show you. When you are on your Amazon, sorry, I just need to change something. Although I think you probably all know my postcode by now. But I don't feel comfortable when that's being shown. yeah, when you are on Amazon, getting your pressure washer, always, 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 when you're getting your link, always a full link. Because I did a video a little while ago, and you can use a find and replace, a search and replace plugin for WordPress, and you can update this tracking ID. because that's the only thing that makes the affiliate link yours. So you can change it. Also, I mean, not only for when you get kicked out of the Amazon program, which hopefully doesn't happen very often, when you come to sell your website, obviously the new owner is not going to want your links all over something, they're going to want their links, and it makes it easier for you and them to update the links when you do that, when you sell your site. So that's why I always say use the long link. Okay, we fixed it for phones, we're good. What the heck, I'm going to leave it over here. New to pressure washing? Washing? Our beginners and buyer's guides are here. We'll help you get started right away. This text is just coming out my head now. It needs adjusting. Obviously, I'll tweak it later. Read beginners guides. Can you still make a long link look pretty? I don't think you need to really, because you'd obviously be linking words or images on your site. So, you know, I might want to make this a link, you know, click the link, paste my long affiliate URL. No one's actually going to see that Amazon link. They're going to see best pressure washer and they click on that. So you're never actually going to show those links on your site. Raymond, I hope that's useful. Can you line the whole block to right in main options or layout and position? Where's the block? I guess I could if there isn't any left, right, or anything. Yeah, you could use a link manager, though keep in mind that Amazon don't like you cloaking. They don't like you hiding links. I'll save, all right. Wow. Okay, let's get another lovely pressure washer image. What have we got? Lovely, lovely. Look at how that fence is coming up. It's beautiful. Just pressure washing an engine there. Why not? It's Thrive. You can find a link to Thrive in the description. It's an affiliate link. I really appreciate it if you use it. I think the roof is pretty cool. Excuse me, the daughter's here. kids, eh? Anyway, she needed a wee as well. Must be that time of day. Is Thrive Builder what is now Thrive Architect? They're different. Thrive Architect is like to do your content and everything, then Thrive Builder is to do your theme. I'm gonna go with this guy on a roof. Two. It's more than enough. So what size is this image? Can we inspect it? Let's have a look. Oh, also, I think we need a little bit of space, don't we? Look, that's a little bit close. A little bit close. It's like 1857 by 720. We'll just make it kind of smaller. Image size. Could probably crop it a little bit. Nice. Let's see what that looks like. Hey, Johnny, good to see you. How are you? Johnny Nine's in the house. Pressure washing the roof. Always like to describe my images as best I can. By the way, I had a good chat last night with Empire Flippers about selling Best Roof Box. So I will have an update for you on that soon. Next, we're going to figure out how to get rid of that white. All is good in the hood. Perfect. All right. Let's get my man on the roof. I haven't had it valued yet, Coob, properly. Sales have actually been good the last couple of days. I like that look. You can move him about. Wait, don't fall off the roof, man. Careful. And then here we've got the overlay. So, you know, we can lighten it, darken it, however we like. In fact, is the blue tint's too much, isn't it? The blue tint's too much. The dark is fine. I'm wondering if it's slightly too dark. Thank you for the like there. I just saw a like come in. Thank you. Nice. Now, in terms of adding a little bit of space, do I just add some margin at the top, do you think? A little bit of margin. I don't know how much margin. I think that looks better already. But I'm wondering if it's too much on the mobile. I'm also wondering if this needs a little bit of margin on the sides, because they're looking a little bit cramped, weren't they? I like it. Yeah, in terms of best roof box, look, if we have a quick look, I'll show you. You know, I was worried earnings and everything were down. Traffic is still not great. But we've had a couple of good $50 days. Like yesterday, I mean, there's the Thule boxes and that are back in stock, which is helping. So, you know, they're getting ordered. Let's have a look at the last 7 days. You know, we've got two Thule's there, we've got a sport rack, good boxes, another sport rack, roof rack system, another Thule box there. Oh, I think it's going to be good. Going to be all right this month. We'll crack on. Oh, hang on. You look at you. I'm giving away my next niche there. I'm not at all looking at slow cookers. Right, let's fix. Let's get rid of this. We've got too many tabs, haven't we? Again, too many tabs. What do we don't want this or this or this or this. Yeah, so this bit of white space, well, what is that? I mean, I guess we'll do it on the desktop. So when you, I've only learned this the other day, with responsive editing, basically it affects all of the sizes smaller. So if you do it on the desktop, it changes everything. If you do it on the mobile, it's only going to apply to mobile or smaller. Do it on tablet, it's going to apply to tablet and smaller. So I guess, I mean, negative margin gets rid of it. But that doesn't feel right to me. What are you thinking? I mean, it's fixed it. What the heck? We haven't got all day. School run's going to be happening soon. Has the footer got padding? Good question. Let's have a look. I know what I'm doing. I'm in the Thrive theme builder. Easy for me to say. Ta-da. Edit. That's not doing anything. What are these decorations? Oh, I see. We could have some fun with them. Well, not right now. No margin, it has got padding, but that's fine. What was that on 40? Negative margin, like I say, that feels wrong. You can just imagine proper web developers going, he's using negative margin. What a faux pas. Right. I'm going to say that the homepage is about done. What are you thinking? Obviously, it's going to evolve over time. It's going to get better. We're going to do some stuff with it. I think what we're going to do now is we need to add a bit of content, don't we? A bit of content. Now, I'm going to jump straight in, I think, and... Okay. How are we feeling about this this blog layout? I quite like it. Quite like it. We need to obviously add the header and stuff, so let's do that. Let me just go in here for a second. Where's my template? I don't want to use a wizard. I like it. That's what we're just doing. Is there not a way to kind of apply the header to everything? It is, Huskan. There's an affiliate link. I've broken the logo. Okay, well let's fix that now. What did I do to you, logo? Oh. Does seem to go back. Where does it go for you, Koo, when you click on the logo? Seems fine. I like it, Joe Friendly. Your picture is slightly scary. All right, let's change this blog post. Bram says I might need to change the logo with the font for. Maybe I should. Do you think we should do? I don't even know if that font is in Canva though, is it? Let's have a look. What was the font? It was. Quicksand. There we go. Better. Like it. Actually, I'm going to do that as a JPEG. Gotta love a free font, haven't you? Where's the other one? Been busy with the Best Roof Box pins, you can see that. Joe, you can give Divi a try. It's not my favorite, but a lot of people love it. Maybe I just haven't been using it properly, as usual. Here we go. I did actually upload both sizes of logo, did I? I don't know if that's something you need to do with Thrive. Get your retina going on. Right, we can come in here and change it, can't we? Recommended size 250 by 40. Okay. I probably just have to upload it. I mean, what size is this? 251/125. Is that going to cut it? What? Okay, I'm not resizing. It looks fine. It looks fine. Okay. So I reckon if I just upload the Retina one, it'll. What? That's the wrong name. It's the wrong name. Jesus. Excuse me. Best pressure washer logo. Perfect. Poppins font. Okay, they're both there. It's that one that's best jet wash. Which was the other site I was thinking of. Okay, it's just because I overwrote the wrong one, didn't I? Just save this again. Best pressure washer logo at 2x. So that's twice the size of the other one. The idea is for retina screens, high-res screens, all that stuff. Okay. I'm going to get rid of that one. Going to upload. I think all you need to do is upload it to Media Library and it will do the rest for you. I find Divi quite difficult to use, weirdly. You're not dressed yet, Bradbury. Good work. Okay, there we go. We've changed some logos around. Perfect. Let's change this default post. Was there no save on here that I needed to save? No save? No. So, header. We need to replace this with my fantastic header. Like that. Now, I quite like this layout. I don't know. I mean, you could. Let's see what else we got. Do we do that, or we just have something real simple? I mean, the image is big, isn't it? What have we got in here? Any? What if there's like a post or something we could use? It's not that, it's no different to the rest, really, Joe. Okay, I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to make it a little bit not quite as high. Lose the date. Lose that. Lose that. That's it. I like the email also, like that's already built in. The rest is good. We don't have a newsletter right now. So bottom, we'll just turn that off. Perfect. Raymond, I got the logo. I just made it in Canva. Canva, so the Canva is free, canva.com. And, you know, create a design, go logo. But actually what I did was I went to like an icon site, like Icon Finder. I don't know if this was the site actually. It was an icon site. Yeah. You know, there is no free ones. It wasn't this site, it was Icon, Flat Icon maybe? I think I'm a member of this one. Pressure Washer. Actually, these are better than the one I've got. But yeah, I got one of these, dropped it onto Canva, added some text, logo done. No, Phil, you can't see which tags are driving traffic. But they say nowadays that tags don't do a lot. Then you know they don't really use tags. Get rid of all this stuff. I'll play with this another day. This layout. Still thinking actually that's a bit too high, and this needs to be more in the middle. Koo's got to go. See you later, Koo. Is there no way to align this vertical? I think that's better. I don't know. I'll tell you what, let's add a bit of content. So I happen to have some content right here. Here we go. Here we go. It's the aluminium siding pressure washer guide. You see that? So let's get it on. First of all, we need an image. Pressure wash metal. Any metal will do. Aluminium ideally. That's a roof. Side, I think, is like the side of a house. I think. What does an aluminium side look like? Not something you really have over here. No, not a side gate. A side. Okay, that's what it looks like. No, it should just do it automatically, scum. Let's see if we got some siding on here. Ah, yeah. Now what we need is siding with a bit of pressure washing. I just see I'm out of images. Okay. Luckily, I've got another stock photography. I've got Adobe. Let's have a look what they've got. I've been using a lot of images recently. Siding, pressure wash. Yeah. This is what we like. Ooh, what do you think of this? Is this wooden siding? What is this? I don't know what type of siding that is. The guy up on the roof is kind of cool. Thanks. Oh, is the cake ready? Is it good? Oh, hey.
Well, you don't ask me to.
Oh, fine. Good. Cake delivery. I haven't got that yet, mastermind. Excuse me. They made banana bread. It's very nice. Anyway, let's not mess around with this. I'm going to go for man on roof. Right. Then what I'm going to do is resize it quickly. I know that this, what size did we go for actually for the old featured? Let me open that one that I just did. Oh, I'm clicking about like a crazy fool. I'm trying to streamline my workflow, but I'm not having much luck. Where's Photoshop gone now? Here we go. Perfect. Okay. So, pressure washer for aluminium. Sorry, I don't know if I did spell that right. Aluminium, I think so. Aluminum, as you might say. Stephen, you're flirting with me. Thank you. Okay. Let's add an article. Let's get rid of all this. We don't need this. We need a new post. And I've got Word right here. I'm going to flick between. Just, I guess it's going to do this. If we, can you see me flicking between? Kind of works, doesn't it? Aluminium siding pressure washer guide. Is it a buyer's guide or a beginner's guide? I think this is a beginner's guide, isn't it? Let's put this in beginner's guide. Let's get that featured image. There we have it. Let's publish. Now let's jump into FireThrive Architect. I don't know if I like this header yet. I don't know if I like the header. Okay, I guess we've got two options now with this this template. Because this post content means it's just going to pull in, you know, if I write stuff here, it's just going to pull that stuff in. But, you know, I want to use the Thrive Architect rather than WordPress, I think. Because there's just more stuff, isn't there? Let's take a look. So yeah, just putting in a bit of text. So let's close that. I should also add a few tags. Siding, aluminum. I think it helps with like the related posts and stuff. Hey Josh, you're back. Okay, so let's edit this. Let's just use the architect. I want WordPress content. I mean, I'm going to start with text, so let's do that. Let's start doing some copying and pasting. Doesn't need H2, it just needs to be a H2. What's up? What is that? Is there something wrong with that? What's wrong with that? Are we spelling it wrong? Do you like how I use Google as my spell? There's nothing wrong with that. What does it need a capital A? What is it? Why does aluminium need a capital A? It's not a name, is it? Is it a name? I don't know. That's a bit weird. Let's just get the text in and then we'll put some stuff. I said I might put AAWP on, didn't I? So we'll see. T, thank you. I guess so. Yeah, it's my turn. I'll get him. Maybe I have to break this into two parts. I might have to come back next week and finish it. For now, let's just get this article on, and then we'll do some we'll do the snazzy stuff next week. Just gonna dump all this in here. I mean, I guess you could just use Gutenberg for the content, couldn't you? But You know, I really wanted to use those, what are they called? The pros and cons things. And there's so much nice stuff in here to use, isn't there? So it was a block and it was pros. Like this. I gotta use that. You gotta use that, haven't you? Look at it. Beautiful. I'm wondering if that needs to be at the top. Come up here. Up the top. Wait. I like it. I wish I could spell. Pros. Makes your siding shine. Too much pressure can damage. I'm an expert already in pressure washers, by the way. Thanks, Phil. Useful. You know, look at this now. It's magnificento. I need to obviously write a summary. What? What do I want this auto? There. I'll have to come back with a summary. I guess I could just take. I can just type something quickly. Pressure washer is a great way to clean your. I'm not using the capital. I'm going to write all this now. I need to think of something. Okay. So here we are. We've got some products. I mean, I guess we could. These need to be a heading. I'd like to bold this. Yeah, next week, because I've got to go do school run in a minute, I will continue this and we'll get it finished. So in here, I mean, if I wanted to add a sight stripe, how on earth am I going to paste some code in? Or do I need to have like a HTML? Maybe. But that, yeah. What are you guys thinking about the site stripe image, or should we just not site stripe it? I don't know. I do, but I don't know if I should have, because I always forget to turn it off. There it is. The pressure Joe. Josh doesn't bother blocking search engines because they're not going to find you with no content or links. So if we get this image, site stripe image, large. I mean, I can't just paste this in here. It's going to just break it. Of course it is. So I'm wondering if we need to kind of break this down a little bit. Have a few extra thingy bobs. Let's just get that out. And here, add some more text. Here, add some HTML. like here. Bosh that in here. Like that. Push this over here like this. Then get our pressure Joe. Don't know how much we can get in here. Like this. It's got too much little space around. I don't know. That looks all right, doesn't it? Let's center that up. And then we're just going to need to drop a little more text in there, like that. Oh, yeah. And then we want to use this anyway. Look at this. Look. We've got another opportunity to use the pros and cons. How exciting. Yeah, I think there's a little too much spacing here. I don't know. We'll see. There's content blocks with loads of these types. Is there? Where do I need to find these blocks then? Oh, yeah. Look at this. Oh, we could do some good stuff here, couldn't we? I mean, in theory, you could just have like this. And, you know, you could just ditch that. Put the... put this in here, look. Look at that. How is this looking on here? All right, indeed. I don't know. I guess what I'm going to do is I'll get a few templates sorted, and then we can, you know, going forward, adding content. Well, when Mac, my editor, adds the content, it'll be fine. I'm going to have to add one of them though, for sure. Which one do we like? I like this one. I like this one. What have we got in the article? What does it say? Things we like, things we don't like. I'm going to get rid of this. Don't need this. I just want this pros and cons box. Daughter's here again. What?
There's a lion.
All right, can you ask Mummy to help you with that? I'm just in the middle of something.
Okay.
Thank you. Kids and wives keep coming in, but that's fine. Here we go. Things we like. Things we don't like. I don't need the conclusion. I'm probably, if I'm going to use this template, I need to just brief my writers to include these things, don't I? That's the trick. That's the trick. We can tackle different cleaning tasks. We can. It's lightweight. And it's got the TSS auto shut off, saves energy when the washer is idle. Many users consider medium duty and not heavy duty. Okay. Okay, and then what else we got? We got another product, the Tiandi. But I think you get the idea, don't you? I'm going to save this and we'll take a look. I like it. I'm liking it. Starting, the Thrive is growing on me, definitely. It's obviously very powerful, got a lot of options, a lot going on, but you know, once you get your head around it, you can make some really great looking stuff. Even I can really quickly. I feel like I've had a lot of tea today. I don't know if I need this tea. I guess you can't have too much tea. Right, I'm gonna go for another 5 minutes, then I've got to get out of here. So let's just finish this article. I will continue this next Thursday. Okay, what we got? The Tiandi. I love some green blobs. Okay. So let's add text. See, now that doesn't look like there's enough space. Does it? Between the things we like and the things we don't like. I don't know what that was. I feel like this needs a little bit of space. At the top, a little bit of margin, 20 maybe, 30 even, it's better. Let's make this the H3. Let's look this up on Amazon. Oh, and that's the thing we need. We need our Amazon button, don't we? Where should we put that? I'm wondering, maybe over here underneath the image. Table of contents. Steve. We've got a choice between call to action, which might be a little bit too much. That's going to be too much, isn't it? And we've got the button. What do you think over there? That looks alright, doesn't it? No, it's fine. I'll get him. I'm just wrapping up.
That's right. I'll go. You can.
No, I'm finished now anyway. I think the button there's fine. And then, of course, we would add our affiliate link in here. Let's go get it. Remember, always use the full link. Well, I've lost my tab. There we go. Button. No follow. Perfect. Right, I'm just going to add this product. So let's look it up. Did I copy it to clipboard? Probably did. Don't want that little bracket. Probably doesn't matter. That looks similar to the other one, is it? It's different, isn't it? Yeah, they're just blue. Blue is obviously the color. For pressure washers. Let's get the image. I mean, yeah, because I think AAWP would be good as well, wouldn't it? It'd be good to have AAWP and have some nice product comparison tables. Now, what size did I make this? Did I set a width 29? I mean, let's just make that better. A nicer number, and we can just do this like that. I guess we can just duplicate this, bring this down. I think it's better than Divi. I'm not sure about being better than Elementor, but possibly. Then we'll get our affiliate link. Stick that in there like that. And then this as well. Again, we can just copy this. Grab that. Bram, why do you love Elementor? Is there something you prefer? Set the table of contents up here. Ooh. Very nice. Where do you think that should sit? Bram, why do you love Elementor? I'm thinking it needs to just start closed. What do you think? Anyway, I'm going to need to love you and leave you. I mean, I guess I'm only getting hassled with this at the moment because I don't know it as well, and I can fly around Elementor because I've used it a bit more. And Elementor's still got its fair share of hassle, that's for sure. What I would do, I will continue this next week. I think 2 hours odd for a stream is plenty for you guys. Plenty for me anyway, I know that. But I think we've created something between us. I've definitely needed you guys in the chat to help me and guide me with this. But I think that this site is coming together quite nicely. And yeah, this logo is not linking properly, is it? We'll fix that next week. But yeah, I think we're getting somewhere. Yeah, I should disable comments. But yeah, I think we'll do a little transition. Is that camera still on? I think it is. Let's try. Thank you. I've enjoyed that. We'll finish it off next week. And then I put a post in the group, the Facebook group, just the other day asking for ideas for this Thursday stream. I've got loads of ideas suggested to me, so I'm going to start working through some of them. Phil says maybe make the menu a little bit less bold. We'll do all that next week. So yeah, same time next week, 1 o'clock again, I think, because start early gives me a couple of hours before the school run to get cracking. And we will get this site looking super good. Super nice. Already looks pretty nice, but we'll make it super nice. I may have a video for you tomorrow. I'm trying to do a video on that new free Ahrefs tool. So might try and get that up tomorrow. Next week, I'm going to, have some more videos for you and live stream and all that usual stuff. But, you know, if I don't see you until then, have a great weekend and good luck with all your projects and all that stuff. Thank you, Bram. I will see you next week. Yeah, I'm going to do a couple more tutorial videos on building affiliate sites, I think. I want to do some stuff on building sites without Amazon. I noticed Ferdy was mentioned, and Ferdy's big video he's just done, he's not using Amazon affiliate, he's doing Invato affiliate, which is a bit different because it's digital products. Hi Albert, I'm leaving now, you've missed it. But you can watch it all again in a few moments when YouTube has done its encoding and all that kind of stuff. But for now, Phil, yeah, do a traffic site for advertising, good idea. Let me do the countdown. 5, 4, sound like Thunderbirds. 3, remember Thunderbirds? I love Thunderbirds. 3, 2, 1. Enjoy the rest of your day. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.